Greetings, Eric Packer, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for spending the time to check this video out, and also we appreciate your support, subscribing to this channel, and checking out the other work that I've completed online, yeastinfection.org, various other blog sites that I've contributed to. So the question today is, can birth control contribute to a vaginal yeast infection or candida infection in women? I just did a video previously on intrauterine devices, so I thought it might be quite prudent for me to do another video talking about the birth control pill, and its link with candida. Many women today take the birth control pill. I may have done a video on this previously, but I'm going to expand a little bit on this one and maybe give a bit more information, which I previously haven't completed. So if we go back a long time ago, when I was a little kid, back in the 60s, the pill, when it came out, was nothing like a pill that it is today. One of the first pills that they produced was called DES, or diethylstilbestrol, which is probably about 50,000 times stronger than the current, combination pills that they make today. It was very, very strong. Some experts that I've spoken to, people that have done an incredible amount of research, believe that the breast cancer rates today are still linked, to the women back then giving birth to, daughters, and they're giving birth to subsequent children. And there could be some link there between women taking that kind of estrogen levels back then in a pill, even pushing that, breast cancer risk through to today. It's incredible. So estrogen is certainly linked with breast cancer and other types of, female cancers, particularly when it's very high in the body and difficult for the body to break down. So estrogen is definitely linked with candida. I've seen this in many, many, many times with women, particularly estrogen dominant women. And we have a lot of women today estrogen dominant between, say, mid to late 30s up to, mid to late 50s. So estrogen's everywhere today. Even plastics, certain types of plastics can mimic estrogen. We call them xenoestrogens. So there are various chemicals that we have today that can mimic estrogen. And for this reason, many people like me prefer, to talk to patients to say, look, try and get away from plastics and toxic personal care products and things like, styrofoam and, those little styrene cups you drink out of and BPA plastics, plastic containers. All these sorts of things can contribute to what we call xeno or foreign estrogens. So just be careful not to load the body up too much with excess estrogen that you don't really want. Estrogen is a proliferative hormone, so it grows, it pushes growth up. So it comes in before the period several days. So it will come in and slowly go down as progesterone goes up. So these two hormones really control the menstrual cycle. But there are two other hormones in the background, also called luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. I'm not going to go into this whole pathway. You can look it up online and study this yourself. Many women tell me that they get vaginal irritation or itchiness or discharge anything from, 2 to 4 or 5 days before the period. And this is very common as estrogen starts to kick in. It starts to prepare the lining, inside the womb and the uterus really for impossible implantation. If the egg becomes fertilized and it implants, estrogen goes up. It makes that area nice and plump and soft. And it allows also the cells to stimulate glycogen, which is a kind of a sugar, which candida loves to feed on. So many women can get this vaginal irritation or cervical irritation from that excess, sugar, for want of a better word, being produced in an area that candida can feed on. Candida albicans is the common one found probably in about 65-70% of the vaginal cultures, but there are other types of candida that are associated as well. So if you are on a pill and you get problems, my suggestion is to talk to the doctor and get off the combination pill and look at a progesterone-only pill. Usually you're less a chance of this kind of vaginal irritation if you go to progesterone-only. There's pills like Yasmin, for example, or various other pills you can get into. Or you may want to look at other kind of methods of birth control as well. Be careful about intrauterine devices, IUDs, because they've got up to 4 or 5 times greater risk of, making sure that candida will hang around than non-users of IUDs. Check out my previous video I did on intrauterine devices and candida. So some women don't get problems with the pill with Candida. Other women get a heck of a problem. So if you notice that you get a cyclical irritation in that area and you are on the pill, go and talk to your doctor and do something about it. Okay, because you can definitely, you know, get free from that. And you may want to give yourself a break from the pill, you know, for 3 or 6 months or more, and then do a proper Candida diet approach, a proper vaginal clean out with boric acid. I've done some videos on this, and you too can be 100% free from this, you know, most irritating, annoying condition. I spoke before a little bit about estrogen dominance. So the important thing to understand is it very much also depends on the health of your liver. So you'll find that by drinking alcohol regularly and eating chocolate and having sweet foods like candies and ice creams, these foods can all really cause problems with you, because they're going to make it harder for the liver to detoxify estrogen very much. Estrogen can build up in the body and create a lot of problems for you. So if you are drinking reasonable amounts of alcohol, you know, and having all kinds of female problems, then my suggestion is for you definitely to cut alcohol back and high fatty foods and maybe lose some weight. Excess body weight in women particularly, but also in guys, definitely contributes to estrogen dominance, as the fat is very estrogen sensitive. So weight loss, liver cleansing, very important parts of keeping estrogen, you know, at a normal low rate. Otherwise, you could end up with serious health problems when you get older. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you got some good information from this video. Thank you.